Welcome to r/maliciouscompliance, where we share stories of people conforming to the letter but not the spirit of request. Thank you guys for subscribing to the channel and for your support in the comments. And today's first story is 3 acts of malicious compliance in one project, rewarded with 4 days of leave fully paid. I used to work for a mining company as a geologist. I left and a few years later was employed by them again, but in a very different role, dealing mostly with compliance-based stuff. We had a new project coming up, which meant a lot of data would be coming in daily, and at some point we would be required to process all that data. The data was being logged into an Excel spreadsheet, which was probably the quickest and easiest way to do it for the data we needed to capture. It did, however, introduce a large margin of human error. The benefit was that errors could be checked later in the corporate office, rather than taking up time in the field, when people were already working 12-hour shifts, and we were paying contractors by the hour. In addition to this, they updated my contract to a field work-based employee, rather than office-based. This allowed them to send me out into the field for several weeks at a time, without any change in pay. It also had a few other conditions which come into play. I had created a spreadsheet during my time there as a geologist that removed a few of the basic errors without any issue. Knowing the current project, I offered to spend some time fixing it up, because I believed I could get it to eliminate all errors with a few very rare exceptions. My department manager approved, but the general manager felt my time was better spent on my actual assigned work. My assigned task was creating 1/1000 scale maps for a 350-kilometer rail network. Fair enough. I did, however, mention that come reporting and analysis time, we would need a way to get that data into a database and into our software. I mentioned I had created something similar in the past, and I felt I could have something up and running within a week if they let me. Nope. Focus on the work you've been assigned. Okay then. Now, my computer skills were far and above that of the other staff members, with few exceptions. Even on the industry software, I was the go-to guy for people who had been in the industry for several years. Knowing this, I knew there would be a time when my help was required. I started making some of the maps, and figured it was going to take several weeks of my time doing it this way. I did some Googling, had a few ideas, and within about 2 hours I had a script ready to run that would automate the process for me. Given that I just shaved several weeks of grinding off my workload, I figured I would take a look at the spreadsheet after all. Here is where my first act of MC happens. The general manager comes in and sees me working on the spreadsheet, tells me that he told me not to work on that and to do my other work. I explained that I thought I had found a quicker way of doing it, so I had some extra time. Nope, do the maps. I loaded up my script, hit run, checked it was all going smooth, and left the office 3 hours early, knowing my machine would be unusable for the next 5 to 8 hours. I came in the next day, and there were hundreds of PDFs on my computer of all the maps. I told my boss and the GM I had finished the maps, and the PDFs are available. I asked to take a look at the data and get something ready. Nope, we need the PDFs in a single file. I explained that it would be a huge file and almost unusable. Just do it. Malicious Compliance Part 2. I set the PDFs combining just after lunch, and went home early again. I can't remember the exact size, but the PDF was enormous. We were working from 5- to 6-year-old laptops that just couldn't cut it. He complained that it wouldn't open, and I explained the issue with the size. He just mumbled and sent me on our way. It got dangerously close to the time when our reports were due to the share market. Because we had no way of putting the data into the database ourselves, we had outsourced that, and were paying someone a very handsome sum to deal with it. Unfortunately, the data we were sending them was full of errors, and constantly had to be rechecked and validated. Eventually, we got the data in the database, and we just needed to generate our statistics and reports which were due in 3 weeks. Turns out the only guy in the office who was capable of doing that was me. I was told exactly what was needed, and how it was to be presented. I explained that it would probably take at least a week, but more likely 1.5 weeks. They said that is okay, it's priority one. I got it all done in 1 week, everyone signed off on it, the senior geologist who had 15 years experience, my manager had 35 years experience, and the general manager, who probably only had 12 years of experience. Everything was good to go for reporting in 2 weeks time. The general manager approaches me 30 minutes before I'm due to leave on Thursday. We're due to submit our reports at 7 a.m. on Friday. He said, I've just been taking another look over these reports, and I think we need to make some changes. We need to report X, Y, and Z for sake of transparency. I explained to him that A, no we don't, because X, Y, and Z aren't about transparency, and they have no relevance to what we're reporting. B, no one else in the industry would ever report X, Y, and Z, because it's not relevant and only raises issues. And C, it took a week to make those reports. He insists. I call in my department manager who backs me up. The GM says, regardless of what others are doing, we need to be sure we're doing the best job we can, and to be proud of what we're putting out as a company. I think doing this shows how committed we are. My boss sighs and calls me into his office alone. He said to do the work and stay late. Take an extra day off for the few hours it's going to take. I explained that I had a dinner reservation, and that I would come back after I had finished dinner, but I couldn't guarantee it was going to get done in any reasonable amount of time. The GM came in and thanked me for my commitment, and to email him every couple of hours with any progress updates or questions, no matter what time of day or night. Malicious Compliance Part 3. I started working on it, spent a few hours on it before heading to dinner for an hour and a half, then back to the office. It got to about 11:30 p.m., and I had barely a third of what was required. I had been emailing my progress throughout. I couldn't take it anymore. I set up some automation scripts, which I knew would get a little more of it done, but not the whole thing. I then set up some timed emails to be sent off to the GM, including one at 3:30 a.m. the following morning, letting him know where the data would be. Friday morning, I get into the office, load up the report that came out, and none of my work is included. Apparently, he had tried to get the executives to include it, but they told him the same things I told him. He saw me and decided to thank me for the late night I pulled. I made a bit of a sarcastic remark about how it wasn't even included, and he sheepishly ignored it. Said he would give me a paid day off for my efforts. That's one. I told my boss, and he said he would give me an extra day off as well. That's two. I reminded the GM that they had changed my contract, and therefore I was already owed a day off, because my shift lasted longer than 14 hours. That's three. Not only that, but because I had not had a full 8 hours break between my shifts, I was owed yet another day off. That's four. This was not the first or last time I maliciously complied to the GM's wishes. It was the first real major one that paid off. There's another story alongside this one, which I might post here as well. The second story is, there's a raise freeze except in case of promotions? Well then, meet my new specialists. Many years ago, I managed a store at a fairly large corporate book chain. While other book chains were going out of business, ours was thriving. We rented our store locations instead of purchasing them, so we were able to shut down underperforming stores quickly, and since the economy was bad, corporate was able to procure low rents when opening new locations or negotiating new contracts for existing spaces. But while the company itself was booming, a raise freeze was in effect at stores and had been for about 2 years. It was pretty demoralizing to know that no matter how hard you worked, you wouldn't be able to receive a raise. But when I got promoted from assistant manager to store manager, I realized that raise freezes were only in effect for people who stayed in the same position. If you got a new position, you could get a raise since you were moving up the food chain and taking on more responsibilities. In addition to management positions, we also had specialist positions available. There was a merchandising specialist who changed the discount stickers every week and set out bestseller and new arrival sections. Magazine and sale book specialists put out the new merchandise in both sections. And finally, we had a specialist in charge of putting all the non-book merchandise out and making sure they were properly discounted once a week. These were things like reading lights, pens, keychains, toys, etc. Once my promotion went into effect, I hatched my plan. I spoke with all my employees and explained that I had found a loophole in the system, and that I was willing to give them a temporary promotion, if they wanted, so that they could get a raise. They could pick one of the positions to learn, and they would be promoted to specialist and get a raise. Then once the raises went through in a few weeks, they would be stepped back down to a cashier position, but keep their raise. This was possible and all on the up and up, according to corporate policy, because it wasn't technically a management position. Then we'd rotate someone else in and repeat the process. At the end, the people who were originally the specialists would regain their original positions and would also get a raise. We had a small staff of around 20, including my management team, and not all employees wanted to participate. Some only worked a shift or two a week, and one full-time cashier wasn't interested in learning anything else, because then people might expect more out of him. But the rest were fully on board. I rotated it pretty carefully, so my district manager didn't have to rubber stamp three positions at a time, and within 4 months, all employees who had participated in my plot had received the maximum allowable raise. As a bonus, we now had at least three people trained in each position. Some of my specialists had lots of vacation time socked away that they never used because they know their section would be a mess if they were gone for very long. Now they were able to take their vacation time or call out sick, knowing they had backup. And the newly cross-trained cashiers enjoyed getting a break from the register sometimes to work on projects. In fact, because they knew the store much better, it made them better at upselling. If they noticed a customer was getting a book by a popular author, for instance, they would show them other books by the author in the bargain book section. And soon we saw a strong improvement in sales overall. It's almost like happy employees do a great job. What a shocker. And the last story is, nasty HR claims policy, and then it's used against them. I used to work for a big global company at one of their many big sites as an operations manager. Loved the job, hated the company. I hadn't gone by my legal name in about 12 years at this point. Everyone knew me by another name. I used it everywhere, all my clients used it, and my name badge even used this name, as there was a section for preferred name. When I started right there on my application, I had zero problems up until the new HR manager arrived. She was a nasty cow, and especially disliked me. At around 8 months working there, I still hadn't received any business cards, and had put in many requests for them over the time. I think maybe the new HR thought she was going to pull one over on me, as she did indeed get my business cards printed, and delivered all 300 to me. All written with my legal name. I questioned this and was told it was company policy, and that I would need to write in my preferred name on each card if I wanted to keep using it. even though there were several other managers who also didn't use their legal names and yet had their business cards printed as they wished. I was singled out. She was so de-smug about it, and at this point, malicious compliance is really my MO. I had never worried about changing my name legally, as it had honestly never really been an issue. People will generally call you whatever you introduce yourself as. But well, opportunity came knocking at my door, didn't it? I spent $160 in a full day at the courts, changing my name legally, and heck, while I'm there, I'll just change my last name too. I was never attached to it, and this one is much better. I also went and applied for a new driver's license, and spent the rest of the afternoon faxing my new documents off to the many places that would need them. It was a lot of work, and it did end up costing me about $200 all up, but walking into work the next day was the most satisfying day of my time there. I was able to hand over my official change of name certificate, and I personally handed the HR manager back all 300 brand new, completely unused business cards with my now previous name. And to top it off, she had to update all my files, and my contract, send everything to head office to be completed, and then had to come crawling back to my office for me to sign each one with my new name. It probably explained the vindictiveness she displayed later, but I ended up quitting not long after. I doubt head office would have liked having to fork out for another set of business cards either. And sure, I had to spend a bit of time and money doing it, but it was something I should have done a long time ago anyway. I just got a little shove in the right direction, and the payout was so satisfying. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you liked it, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button. Have a good day!